Well, I think he's a very interesting figure, because what he did was to try to build new kinds of knowledge institutions. He thought that what we had emerging in the world in terms of the fragmentation of knowledge, new technologies for communication that were emerging, these presented immense possibilities for new approaches to the organization, dissemination and use of information. And so he speculated about new institutional forms that might be required, new machines and so on. He tried to build these institutions physically, he was inhibited because he was working in the environment of the card, the book, paper, wooden cabinets and so on. But what he was doing at that time now has digital equivalents that are quite remarkable in their scope. And so in addition to those physical manifestations, Otley, in a very systematic way, began to think about how we might approach understanding information phenomena, the information management, access, and so on, in new ways that would bring all the different formats into some coordinated form, so that there weren't distinctions, unnecessary distinctions between what was in print, what was in audio form, what was an image, what was in a museum, what was in an archive, what was in a public administration, the files in a public administration. How could we find some way of bringing all that into a coherent, ordered environment that was networked across the world?